Got a Kenworth 2013. Customer complaining his engine I own is losing power, so we just gonna go diagnostic. Definitely we got our Nexix. So we're just gonna plug. Shit. I just plugged the computer, Nexix, that's the Kenworth. Yeah. Nice. So Kenworth. So now just gonna put the key on. Okay. Okay, so we got it, this Kenworth. Of course you gotta put the key on. See, air pressure too low, engine warning. So we got the light, a stop light. But music. So as a truck diagnostic, we always have all the softwares. So we got every single software, so there is no truck cannot stay without diagnostic. So we can diagnose any type of trucks. So we got a manual we got a Cummins. So this truck, it's a Kenworth 2013 Cummins engine. We're using our Cummins software. So first thing we're gonna go is to diagnostic. Connect. Okay. It's gonna take a little bit while you get in. So in the meantime, I can show you the truck. This is a Kenworth 2013. So there is another plug right here as OBD. So this OBD using to diagnostic as a for ABS. ABS light on. So that's the plug for ABS. This plug is for the transmission and ECM engine. So this is for the Wavcom for ABS. So now we back to the program. We get into the software. Let's click OK. So now we creating an image. Okay. We're gonna go to false codes. And we're gonna go up. Okay, so that's the code we have right here. After trimming, SCR intake temperature sensor, voltage are not surely too high, engine protection to derate, coolant level. So that means we got a coolant level is maybe it's low, we're gonna go check. This sensor, we worry about. So let's check the first thing, the coolant level. So let's see. So that's right here, the coolant level. So it's showing us the code for that. So we're seeing like it's got a leaky, so we gotta replace this. So it's kinda low. So he has to replace the tank and gotta put more coolant, okay? That's the first code. Of course, if you got a low coolant, the truck is gonna shut off. You're gonna go with the red light on, it's gonna shut off. So pay attention over that, any type of truck. You got a coolant level low, it's gonna reduce power and I'm gonna shut off. Okay, so the next code, let's go see it. So now we got the second code, so we know that this one engine talk with me, this derate mode. So let's go for this one. I go with this one, double click and see what is the code right here. Send me straight to the pins, catalytic temperature. So I gotta follow in the diagram where it's located. Let me see if I can. Okay. So it's up the trimming engine control, has two ones. Okay, so we got a connector, so maybe it's right here. Okay, so we're gonna go take a look what is the sensor. So, okay, we diagnostic this truck, like I say. We're gonna go to, let's go to, okay, so we're back to the program now. I wanna see what is the problem reading on this one is here, so I go to parameters, yes, and close this one. Let's see. So yeah, I did a mistake. I'm sorry about that. We gotta go to data monitor. That's the page that we gotta go. We're gonna see the temperature right there. So we're gonna go, I choose all of them. So from there, I gotta go after streaming. Okay, let me see, after streaming, intake temperature sense. After treatment, intake temperature sensor. Okay, we got it. Okay, we got it. Intake. After treatment. So we got after treatment. Let's see. After treatment. We got after treatment. And it's got the intake temperature. We got 89. So maximum, we gotta go to trim and disapprove it a little. Trim intake. Trim and, okay, outlet. Trim and after trim, this particular video. Trim filter. The trim intake nook sensor. Okay, here we go. We got up to trim intake temperature, we got it. So it's reading 5 volts, just it's maybe it's a wire, something is touching right there. Because we're reading good voltage right here. See outlet 91. Okay, now here is the problem. Why we're reading minus, you see, minus 40, huh? 40. And right here we're reading 90. So we got it. It's either the sensor or wire problem, you see. We're gonna investigate what's the problem, okay? So we come into under the truck. So we got a DPM right there, DOC right there, temperatures, DPF temperature sensors. And now right here, it's our sensor. So looking at right here, that's the sensor we're talking about, okay? This is the sensor. The intake, so remember that's the outlet. Okay, let me see. Oh, here you go. Okay, that's the outlet. It's here, outlet. So that's right here, the intake, outlet, after treatment, intake, after treatment, outlet. So intake and exhaust, I mean intake and outlet. So that's intake and that's outlet. So intake is before catalytic and outlet is after catalytic. So this is the sensor. So we're just gonna go investigate what is the problem. So the first thing what I'm gonna do is have the key on the truck with the key on. I'm gonna put the multimeter and I'm gonna see how much ohms I got on this sensor. And this one, I compare both of them. If both of them has the same, that means it's not a problem with the sensor. If let's say this one gets lowest and that's got it, let's say this one has more ohms than this one, so that means that sensor is not good. It has to be even. That has to be like exactly the same, but kind of the same. So that's how I do. Oh, if it's easy way, you can remove this one and put that. It's kind of the same sensor, so it doesn't matter. So if the code is going to inactive, that's the problem. Oh, there's another way. You unplug the sensor, you go up, and you see what code you have, new code. You should have a open circuit or high. If you say it's high, so that means the sensor, you know, we have to replace it. So that's the way, that's the easy way to diagnostic on these trucks. So, and I see another thing, it's, if you see this wire, maybe as the wire is touching to the exhaust. So I'm gonna see, I'm just gonna go get my tester, my multimeter, and see, okay? I'm right here in the back, but it's kinda difficult. There's no room. I'm trying to unplug right here, Hey, I'm gonna go do the easy way. I'm gonna check with the power probe if I'm getting power to there first. If I don't get, if I get a power, then I'm gonna go with the multimeter check button sensor. But if I don't have no power in there, so that means a wire somewhere is broke. So it could be there, you see? Could be there or could be in the back because it's touching exhaust. So I gotta see. Okay, we back over here. I gotta remove that bracket. See, that bracket I had to remove to put it down. So I'm using it a power proof, okay? So I'm gonna check the plug. Okay, see, we got a ground. And let's see, we got it. Okay, we got a voltage right there, 5 voltage. You cannot really see because I got it. The flashlight on. Okay, so we got a, okay, we got a voltage. So that means the sensor not good, okay? Easy diagnostic. So this sensor is not good. We had to replace it and the truck is good to go, right? Thanks for watching. See you next video.